Hey everyone, thanks so much for joining us today. My name is Laura and I am a graduate student at UC Santa Cruz and a researcher at NOAA. Today we're going to talk about fish genetics, but first we need to talk about what genetics actually means. So living things are made up of cells that are so small that we cannot see them without a microscope. And there are different types of cells for different body parts. But in every cell in the body, and your body, my body, basically the body of any person you could ever meet, their cells have blueprints for constructing and operating that body. So we call these blueprints genes, and the language that these blueprints are written in is called DNA. So the study of genes and everything related to them is called genetics. So all living things on Earth have blueprints in their cells that code for making themselves. And fun fact, even though the code looks different between different species, every organism on Earth uses the same coding language to write. So I think that's pretty cool. So genetic code between members of the same species is more similar than genetic code between members of two different species. But that doesn't mean that the code is identical between individuals of the same species. So these genetic differences can sometimes code for differences in behavior and appearances in the species that scientists study. And this is why genetics is a really, really cool and important tool for scientists. So I study genetics in steelhead and rainbow trout. Although steelhead and rainbow trout are the same species of fish, they look and behave really differently. So both hatch as babies in freshwater, but only steelhead migrate to the ocean. A lot of research has found that genetics plays a role in if a fish becomes a steelhead or if it will become a rainbow trout. But exactly how much power genetics have on this is unknown. So the environment a fish is in is also very important if they'll stay there or not. So kind of interesting to figure out exactly how involved genetics is. So, to recap, today we learned a bit about genetic blueprints of every living thing and how they hold directions for building the body, and what exactly that body looks like and what it does. We also learned about how genetics are a useful tool for scientists working to understand the code behind interesting species features. So that was a lot of very complicated stuff, so congrats on making it through. Thanks for stopping by. See you next time.